people out here like really big nails?
I love big nails.
You love big nails. All you have to do is find a woman who loves big sideburns. That's all. Thank you. All right. Well, because this is such a big show here today, we have some big judges here today who will be judging our ladies with high hair and long nails. Our first judge, you may have seen how big she really is because she posed for Playboy magazine. She's more well known as the host of USA's Up All Night, and you can see why. Say hello to the outrageous and very beautiful Rhonda Shear.
Big.
Love you too. Now,
you gotta have big hair.
You have big hair, don't you? Yes.
It's a qualification to be a judge on this show.
What does it say about a woman if she has?
It says that if you have big hair, you don't notice how big the hips are. It's sort of,
no. Good answer. Well, our next.
It says that you can hide.
What's that?
You can hide a small man in there.
You can hide a small man in there,
never
right?
Mind.
So you're never lonely.
Never lonely.
Okay. Our next really big judge is someone who also has big hair, and he was one of the biggest singing sensations of the 60s. Please welcome the man who is still tiptoeing through the tulips, Tiny Tim. And we've known each other throughout the years, Tiny. But I wonder if your musical style has changed at all through the years. Do you do any rap now or anything like that?
You gotta pray just to make it today. Gotta pray just to make it today. Gotta pray just to make it today.
Okay.
And he's always had big hair.
What?
He has always had big hair.
Yes. He has
big long hair.
He's got big everything there. You got a big ukulele there in the bag.
And Mr. Bay, it's nice being on you. Thanks for having me on your show.
Oh, sure. Were you going to strike a few chords for us on the ukulele?
Well, this is a lovely. Okay.
Tiny, do you ever get tired of that song?
I never bite the hand that feeds me.
Okay. Well, our next guest is the founder of Screaming Queens, the one and only Dragagram Entertainment Service. Say hello to a big-haired transvestite, Misunderstood. Now, Rhonda Shear, that is big hair.
I feel so understated today.
What?
I feel like a drip.
Oh, you could film Heart of Darkness in that hair. How long did it take you to get that hair ready for today?
Well, it's actually my natural hair. I just wash it and shake it out.
What keeps that hair up like that?
I'm just kidding. Actually, I have to admit it is a wig, and there's a small third world country of bald people running around, but they've got enough rights now to last for months.
Okay.
With all the money they made.
Those are our big judges. Let's get on to our contestants with big hair and big nails. You ain't seen nothing until you've seen this. Our first contestant is a big-haired babe who washes her locks every day. She waits 2 hours for it to dry, then she spends another 1.5 hours teasing it, curling it, and fluffing it. Say hello to Angel. Now, wait a second. Hello. How are you? Thank you. Now, wow, boy, that is really... I thought maybe you saw a mouse in the green room or something, and your hair just went up. Didn't Frankenstein's Bride have a hairstyle like this? Do you remember that movie? Yeah. Now, how do you sleep on this? You don't. You sleep. I gotta say, no, wait, give her a break, because this is, it's just like Jeopardy. That was such a tough question to ask. Rhonda, what?
This is so fabulous.
Yes?
I love this hair, because it's not moving.
Okay.
Orgasm or no orgasm, that hair is not moving.
Right?
Well, you know what I'm saying.
I know.
No, really, you can do anything, and that hair is not going to move.
Yes, that's right.
And this
right.
is a good thing, Richard.
In fact, she will probably cross the river back to New York, and the hair will still be
this
here.
This is fabulous hair.
What score will you give her?
Where are these scorecards? I think this is, no.
Remember, there's more hair to come.
Yeah. I mean, there's like, this is a 9.
A 9. Tiny Tim, what's your score?
I would say it is a 9. I would.
A 9 as well.
Yeah, I think.
Okay, and misunderstood, what do you say?
Well, if Snow White was the fairest of them all, this one is the fairest one at the mall.
Yes.
And I give her an 8.
Fairest at the mall, Angel. Thank you very much, Angel. Our first big hair. Now, our next contestant could put any beauty supply shop in business. She buys a dozen bottles of shampoo at one time, and when she paints her nails, she uses a whole bottle of polish. Say hello to Elvira. Look at these nails. Would you scratch my back a little bit? Yeah. Oh, boy, that feels good. Oh. Oh. Can you drive a car with these nails?
Enough steering wheel.
Boy, that's how long does it take you to grow nails like this?
Like 4 or 5 years.
4 or 5 years,
yeah.
Really? So, do you have to take when you're sleeping? If you turn over, you can crunch your nail.
Or sleep like this, more or less.
Oh, but watch out. You know, Tanya Harding's one of our contestants. I heard she hired somebody to run around with a bat to break your nails. Yes, run to Shear.
There has to be a test for their nails.
What do you mean a test?
The hair can be totally fake. We're into fake hair,
right? Right.
No, but we are. I don't know if you agree, but the nails has to be real. So can you come over here and, like, pick up this change with those nails? This is a little nail test.
Let's see.
That was very smart.
In fact, here's an old Subway token I found up here. There you go. All right. What's your score, Rhonda?
Well, you know, she had hair and nails, and hair and I have to give
it
a 10
nails?
Thing.
A 10!
It's a 10.
For hair and nails. Listen to that applause.
Hair and
Hold on.
Nails.
Wait a second, folks. Can you applaud again? Listen to this thing.
I love that.
Oh, my God. That's a... Ooh. Sounds like false teeth chattering. Yes, Tiny Tim.
Well, I think the nails are fantastic. Yes. And I think the hair is very nice. I would give it a 9.
You'd give her a 9, and misunderstood.
Well, I have to say one thing. If I had nails like that, God, I hope she's dating someone, because she wouldn't have that much fun by herself.
Okay, yes.
But...
Okay, a 9. Congratulations,
her a 9.
Hair and nails. Great scores. For our second contestant, Elvira, now please welcome Lynn, who says that her high hair and long nails are part of her identity. She says she goes through at least 2 cans of hairspray a week.
That's good.
And her nails are a true work of art. Well, thank you very much.
Hi,
Lynn.
How are you doing?
Yes, now why do you do this?
It's part of my identity. I've had it for like so long. And it helps me. It's just...
It helps you what?
Make money.
Make money, okay. Okay. Let's not even begin to ask further questions here. Rhonda.
First of all, not only good hair, and the nails are good. Look, they're very creative. Look at those nails.
Yeah, oh, my
They've
God.
They've got
yeah.
daisies on
That's
them.
True. That's
this
true.
This is a fabulous thing.
All right, so what would you score? Would you give them for creativity?
I'm really high. This is high. This is hard today.
Fine.
Because on top of she had personality, she kissed you.
This is...
And that's a woman after my heart. So,
a 9. Congratulations.
Very,
that's great.
Fabulous.
And Mr. Tim.
Well, I think... As Ms. Shear says, the nails are original and
nails.
The hair is nice. I think the first one was a little more striking,
right?
But I would give her a 7.
You really take this seriously, Tiny. I'm glad to see that. Yes. Misunderstood.
Well, if I had hair like that, I'd be afraid a bird might come and lay an egg in it.
That's a good
what
thing.
What do you give her?
I give her an 8. That's
an
fabulous.
8. Congratulations. Very good score. That's Lynn, our third contestant. But there's more to come, and boy, boy, do I see hair back there. So don't go away, come back hair in just a few moments.
this police officer. It does not matter.
Who are proud of it.
If I see you and I'm attracted to you, hey, it's on. As simple as that.
Despite opinion.
We can be at a family get together and she comes in and tells Grandma and Grandpa like they really want to hear it.
Despite the risks.
If I die tomorrow, I would die a happy person.
They can't get enough men.
What's that time like for you when the rodeo's there?
Cowboys. Yeehaw.
I'm Jeffrey.
Thanks to Russ, I got $5.2 million.
Is this going to be a great summer or what? 1-800-578-7878 for summer fun with peanuts at Travelodge.
Big enthusiasm for our big hair, big nails contest with our big judges. What are you doing with that orange up
there?
Well,
you know, a true nail test to see. You know, nails have to be real for me.
Right.
Fake hair's good. Fake nails aren't. So I want to see if they can peel an orange with their nails.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you, during the break, I had a lot of questions out here in the audience, and these are questions that you will not hear on Oprah or Donahue, believe me.
Yes!
But they have questions concerning all sorts of routine activities that these people might partake in. But first, let's continue with our contest. Contestant number 4 is a woman who is 5'3" tall, but says people always ask her about her height without her huge hair. Welcome, hairdresser, nail technician, Deirdre. Hairdresser.
I am.
So you want to look this way on purpose, right?
Yes.
Yes. On Fridays, I guess, is it still Blowout Fridays where girls go in and get their hair blown out on Friday?
Sure, yeah.
Okay, let's go to Rhonda Shear. Rhonda Shear.
A fabulous makeup, fabulous hair. Why can't I find hairdressers? They always want to give me the natural look. I hate the natural look.
This is the natural look.
This is the natural look.
And what kind of a score would you give? I don't think your nails are long enough for the orange test.
Not
real. They are. Let's see. She can do them. Watch her do that. Wow, she can bite the orange.
So wait a second.
Heck with the nails.
That's how I peel it.
That's good.
That's how you peel it.
I'm not going to break a nail for that.
Okay, see? So this is a good thing.
Are there other things you can't do because your nails are too long?
I can do everything.
You can do everything. And okay, Rhonda Shear, what score will you
give her? I think she means that. Oh, no, she's got to get a higher score. How about an 8? Is
an
that good?
8, good score.
She's fabulous.
Tiny, what's your score?
Well, I think she's very nice. But it's more of an average look, and I would give it a 6.
A 6, he says. Yes, and misunderstood?
Well.
Misunderstood, what's your score?
If I had hair like that, I'd scrub.
Okay, misunderstood.
If I had hair like that, I'd be scrubbing pots with it when I'm at home. I give her an 8.
An 8, all right, not the highest score. But it is stiff competition here, especially stiff when hairspray is used. Here's a gal who says her nails have been compared to claws. She says she can do everything with her nails except go bowling. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Where's that coke can?
Wait a second here. Get the tape measure out. These nails are real?
Yes.
How many years it took to grow these nails?
About 10 years.
10 years?
Mm-hmm.
How do you sleep at night and make sure you don't roll over on them?
Oh, I just sleep like this.
You just sleep like this?
Mm-hmm.
You can't go bowling, but you can.
No.
Can you go swimming?
Sure.
You go swimming with nails like this?
Yes, I do.
And I bet you're a good match for a lobster when you run into one, too.
Oh, yeah.
You have bigger claws. All right, let's measure these nails and see. It's hard to say because they're curled around, but I would say here, put it all the way on the edge, bring it all the way around the middle, and bring it all the way around. 9.5 inches long on her nails. Hold on, because you may not come back. There is a question in the audience that must be asked. Stand up, please, over here.
How do you wipe your
I don't know. I can't even imagine. I can't even.
Richard!
What?
I love this show. You will never hear that question asked on the Miss America
That's
cast.
And everybody wonders about that,
never.
Don't they?
Well, they
All right, now wait a second. Let's give her the orange here. Can you peel the orange?
Sure.
Look at that.
She's
Very
doing
good.
The orange.
Yeah.
She is doing the orange. Could you do a Coke can?
Sure.
Wait, now she can do the Coke can. You know, girls, we cannot do the Coke can.
A Coke can is very difficult. All right, here we go.
We'll hold the
Take
orange.
The orange, yes.
You're like, this is an amazing thing.
Oh, God, now shaking.
She's not, it's not
Wait
easy.
Wait a second, can she do it? It's, let's see.
Go, baby, go, girl, go, girl, go, girl.
She got it!
Yes!
There you go! Truly amazing!
Yes!
Now, thank a 10 you, for that. You are incredible.
That's 10. She's got 10 nails.
And
those are 10 nails.
In the next segment, we are not going to take you into the ladies' room and answer her question. Yes. Tiny Tim, what's your score?
Well, I think the nails are fantastic.
Yes.
If there was just a slight addition, like the first girl with the hair, I would have given her a 10. But I was to give her a 9.
A 9? Yes. And what do you say, misunderstood?
Well, that 9.5 inches was kind of impressive, but I can top that anyway.
Okay.
I give her a 9 for those nails.
Thank you very much. All right. Just walk right off there. Our next contestant says her hair is so big that a bird mistook it for a nest, started picking at her head. Please welcome Adrian. I think it's on fire. Did a bird actually come over and start picking
it? Yes, it did.
It did? Okay, Rhonda Shear, what's your score?
You know, I like the color. It's a very interesting color.
It looks like it's on fire.
I like that fire thing. Yeah. This is a 9.
A 9. Tiny Tim, what's your score?
Is that her real hair?
Is this your real hair?
It is my real hair.
Well, I think the original style is wonderful. If there was an addition of the nails, I'd give her a 8.
An 8? What do you say, Miss Anderson?
I'm sweating. Could you come fan me with that?
Yes, you could.
I give her a 10.
Right there, right?
I think that's wonderful.
A 10. Thank you very much. All right, coming down the home stretch now, we have a big hair, long haired woman who uses 2 cans of hairspray a week. Will scratch anybody's eyes out with her finger like claws if they have a problem with them. Welcome Tracy here. Vega's the last one, though. We can see that. It's high, but I would say this. You're the Tanya Harding. We've seen 2 Nancy Kerrigans here. What do you say?
There's a glitter thing going, an overall look, good nails. I'm going to go with an 8.
An 8. All right, Tiny.
Well, I think a beautiful young lady, and I love the originality. I wish there were a little more, but I'm going to give her a 7.
Okay, a 7. And misunderstood, finally.
I'm a sucker for any girl with glitter in her hair. I give her a 9.
A 9. All right, a good score from Tiny. And the last of our contestants adores her nails and absolutely loves the attention she gets because of them. Please welcome Lisa. And of course, she has long, curled nails of many colors. Very impressive. All right, Lisa. Lisa, let's take a look at those nails here. Nah, they're not as long as the last nails, but they are beautiful.
They are gorgeous.
Oh, you did that yourself? You painted them all? Turn to the camera over here so they can get a good shot of them, because really, she has Michelangelo and Botticelli
all
over her
nails. Richard, she said she was a nail technician.
A nail technician.
What is a nail technician?
Manicure nails. I put acrylic tips on.
They are so gorgeous.
But they are beautiful.
Thank you. That's for sure.
Rhonda, what's
your
score?
They are. It would have been a 10, but we just need a bigger hair, so a 9.
9. Yes. What do you say, Tiny?
9.
I think they're very beautiful and very delicate. I think it's a great originality there.
Yes, Tiny.
If it was just a little, since we're judging a hair and nail contest,
yes.
Unfortunately, the hair was a little.
All right, Tiny. Yes.
I'll give it an 8.
What do you say? All right, 8. Okay, I misunderstood.
I hate to see her have to pick her nose. I'll give her a 9 for the pretty color.
A 9. Congratulations. All right, we'll tally up those scores. And when we come back, we'll take a look at our long-haired, high-haired women and some women who say, this is just ridiculous. Well, it is ridiculous, but the show is ridiculous. But they say the whole look is ridiculous, and they're crazy to do this. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
This is my Katie. I remember that morning. She slept through the night and woke up dry for the first time in ages. It must have been her new Pampers Ultra Dry Thins. They're nearly 50% thinner and work like no Pampers ever to absorb virtually on contact to help stop leaks better. And that means Katie stays drier. And I've got a special memory.
New Pampers Ultra Dry Thins for girls. Shop for the everyday values on Pampers at Lucky.
By the window, that is where I'll be come tiptoe. Through the
tulips will be.
And that song was a really big hit in the 60s, which just goes to show you that we were just as silly then as we are today. Okay, we have some new guests on our panel here today who think that this sort of cultivation of long hair and long nails is stupid and superfluous and perhaps can be even damaging to the impressions women give to the world at large. Lorraine says that these big-haired, long-nailed babes look like they were just electrocuted. She says any man who finds these women attractive should have his head examined. Now, there is a man down here who finds them very attractive. Stand up, please. And you have...
I love her.
I can see from your haircut you have had your head examined, right?
Yes, I have, actually.
Yes. Okay.
Big hair is great.
Okay. Next, meet Helene, who says the higher the hair, the lower the IQ.
True.
She also doesn't like long nails. She views them as personal daggers. And then there's Robin, who says big-haired, long-haired beauties have misguided energies. She feels they need to get a life other than the one that is focused on their appearance. Those are our new guests. Please welcome all of them to the show. Now, Lorraine, you hit upon something right off the bat. You said that there are men who find this attractive and they should have their heads examined. But I have to tell you, I find large hair very attractive and sexy
Richard.
Myself. I mean,
disgusting.
Why is what's this
about
it?
So ugly.
You look like, think that's attractive?
You are so
you
ugly.
That's attractive? It's standing
you know what
like
they remind me of a Marsha Brady fan
Excuse
club.
Me, okay?
Were
they playing elephant music? Weren't they
you
playing the elephant music
right.
when she
Please
came
sit
out?
Down.
Well, hold on.
You are ugly. Don't
but
speak.
Liberty. It's like sticking straight up in the air.
Lorraine.
Sure.
Lorraine, one of the reasons probably why this is a style is because men are attracted to it.
I don't think they are. I don't think they are at all.
Oh, I don't want
you don't
How
think,
can it be so?
Stop.
How can it be? It's
I'm
not them. It's fake. It's like not them. I mean, why, how can that be natural?
You don't know what I am.
It's fake.
It's not, fake?
I'm a finisher.
Do something with myself because you ain't getting no guy looking like that.
I'm afraid to see what she's like underneath that.
Underneath what?
It's like a tightrope.
You need a degree in brick. You need a demolition degree just to see what you have underneath that makeup.
I have a degree, sweetheart. Y'all look like the Three Musketeers. Y'all look like the Three Musketeers.
All right, hold on. So hold on.
Shut up.
I don't want to hear you.
Shut up.
Airhead.
All right, you told me before
you
that you made money
yes,
because your hair was
University.
Higher, that it helped you to
That's
make money.
What? Right.
I'm sorry, are you on this show or are you on some other show? Hold on for a second. Right, okay. Basically, you told me you work as a bartender
right.
and men come in. Why do you think they give you more money if your hair is high?
Because I'm more outgoing and I stand out. I mean, if someone like this was standing there, I don't think they would want her to serve her a drink.
Okay. Now, what
are you talking about me?
I'm just talking about y'all.
But what do you see? She says that men like this, and men respond favorably to this. What do you see?
A certain type of men respond favorably to this.
What
Maybe
kind of
men? Maybe she gets the truck drivers
She's
and this type of
man.
But I get a classier type of man.
Okay, so what do you see when you look at her, for instance, or her?
I see someone a little loose, I have to say. A little loose and a little bit has no brain.
Questions out here in the audience. Anybody have a question? You have something to say?
That ain't fair.
No? Okay, back over here. Stand up, please. Yes.
You're so ugly, you should get yourself a horse, man.
What are you talking? Who's he talking to?
And look at that. Coming right from Mel Gibson, who came down to our studio here today. Yes, questions over here. Who has a question? Stand up, please. Go ahead.
First of all, those three over on the end, you can't say anything bad against them because at least they take care of themselves. You can see it right from there. Because
That's
you,
right.
I mean, you look like the before and they're the after. I mean, you
okay.
can't.
Questions back here? Come here. Let me hear from some women. Now, would you find that an attractive look?
I wouldn't call 6 feet in the air attractive.
6 feet in the air. Well, some of your friends sitting here are well, she's about 3 inches in the air, no?
Yeah, but I wouldn't want attention. You, all that attention for wearing my hair.
I know, that's why you dressed down today to come on the show, I can see. I'm sure the guys online didn't pay any attention to you. All right, so what was your question for them?
I don't know, I think they look ridiculous on the left. And I think they look good. I think they look really good.
Ridiculous. What's wrong with the way I look? What's ridiculous about the way?
All right, we're going to take a break, but we will be right back in just a few moments. Stay with us. What's the secret? How did all of these people end up online here for the Richard Bay Show? What'd you have to do? Hawk the family jewels?
Uh-huh.
No, you didn't. No. What'd you do? Mortgage the house? No, no, of course you didn't. These people have all been lobotomized before they arrive here. Look at this. Wake up. You're about to go on TV. It was very easy. All you had to do was pick up the phone and call a number. It's 392-TIXX, area code 201. And how much did the tickets cost you?
Free,
absolutely free. You don't have to hawk the jewels, put a second mortgage on the house. All you got to do is pick up the phone and call right now. Who are you going to call? 392-TIXX, area code 201 if you're outside of our area.
Do you ever wonder what the future holds? What card has fate dealt to you? Will you enjoy success? Fame? Is there health and happiness in your fortune?
Call the world's best psychics toll-free at 1-800-444-4C.
And discover your true path to destiny.
Show, big hair, big nails, big names in the world of show business, and now we have a big boffo ending coming up. That applause is too big. Thank you very much. I'd like to thank all of our big-haired, big-nailed people for competing here today on our first Big Hair, Big Nail contest. Our judges as well. Now, Rhonda, you have a new show coming up. What is that?
Yes, it's called The News. It's a first-run syndicated show. I'm very excited about it, and of course, up all night.
Okay, now... Misunderstood, you have a service where people can get, what, telegrams delivered by...
They can get dragograms and drag performers. It's called Screaming Queens, and it's Linden in New York.
Okay, and Tiny Tim, what are you doing these days?
Well, I will be appearing in a place called Spooky World.
Spooky World, yes.
In Berlin, Massachusetts, from September 30th to October 31st with Bobby Pickett of the Monster Mash.
Are you
okay.
single?
He's single now. I know, you and Miss Vicky broke up a long time ago.
I have a second wife leaving, too.
Your second wife is leaving, too.
How would you leave
okay,
too?
We're leaving as well. So our big boffo ending will have all of our big-haired, big-nailed people on the stage say goodbye and dance out to break. Thank you for joining us. And from all of us here to all of you, as always, all our best. Thank you.
He's the host that'll leave you talking. Don't miss a minute of The Rush Limbaugh Show coming up today at 3. And now, friends and family confront loved ones who are living life on the wild side on Jenny Jones next.